Yo, what's good, guys? Another video here, and today, as you can see up here, I just reacted to Eminem Kim, and I realized I already saw that before. So, I mean, if you guys want to see that, like, I did do a full video, so we can. I'll put that out if you guys want to see it, but I don't know if you guys want to see like a secondhand reaction, like not like I didn't remember the lyrics, but we're not talking about that, okay? We're talking about this here. Be careful what you wish for. Eminem, yeah, let's roll
news, Detroit rapper Eminem cancels his sold-out European tour to check himself into rehab after admitting an addiction to sleep medication. We'll have more on this story as it develops.
Damn.
Shady Records recording artist Obie Trice has apparently survived a gunshot to the head in what appears to be a random drive-by shooting, while Eminem is rumored to be on and off again relationship with
just in, a tour bus involving Eminem's aunt.
Updating a story we brought you earlier about gunfire at an after-hours club, we've learned that the rapper Proof has been fatally shot.
Damn.
Longtime best friend of Eminem and a member of the rap group D12.
Back in the news again today.
Is it a sabbatical or the end? The rumors and speculation continue to
this
swirl
is like
around Eminem. He insists he's just taking a break, but doubters believe he's retiring. Leaving us all to ask, will the real Slim Shady please stand up?
Oh, wow. That man for real did that. He's dead ass it. Wow. That's crazy. That's actually kind of crazy. He said, leaving us all to ask, will the real Slim Shady please stand up? Man, that's crazy, though. Like, that's some real shit. That is a lot of crap he went through. Like, that's what made him so crazy in his songs, because his whole life was just insane. That's probably why Eminem's music today is so much different than it was back then, because today, Eminem's life probably isn't as crazy. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm sure he has his crazy shit now too, but like, compared to back then, I guarantee you he's calmed down a lot in his life, and that's probably why his music reflects on that. Hey, let's see what he has to say though.
This is it. This is what I wish for. This isn't how I envisioned it. Fame to the point of imprisonment. I just thought the shit would be different. But something changed the minute that I got a whiff of it. I started to inhale it, smell it, started sniffing it, and it became my cocaine. I just
hold up, hold up, hold up. I just want to bring that up. He said fame became his imprisonment. Because think about it, Eminem is so famous now. He can't go out shopping because the whole store will just crowd him. Like, he can't live a fairly normal life. So it's like he's got a point there. Like, for the rest of his life, he will always have that kind of, I can't go out to the grocery store. I can't go out to the mall. I can't go out and, you know, it's crazy.
I started to inhale it, smell it, started sniffing it, and it became my cocaine. I just couldn't quit, I just wanted a little bit. Then it turned me to a monster, I became a hypocrite. Concert after concert, I was raking in the dough, rolling in green. Had the game hemmed up like a sewing machine. But I was losing my freedom, there was nowhere for me to not go and be seen, and just go and be me, and there was no.
That's literally what I was just saying. Like, he can't go anywhere and just be himself. He's stuck in his house all day.
In between, you either loved it or hated. Every CD, critics gave it a 3. Then 3 years later, they go back and re-rate it and call the Slim Shady LP the greatest. The Marshall Mathers was a classic. The Eminem show was fantastic. But Encore just didn't have the caliber to match it. I guess enough time just ain't passed yet. A couple more years, that shit'll be illmatic. And 8 years later, I'm still at it. Divorced, remarried. A felon, a father, sleeping pill addict, and this is real
damn.
talk. I feel like the Incredible Hulk. My back has been broken, I can still.
He said, I feel like the Incredible Hulk. My back has been broke. They still. But hold up, that's not even what I want to talk about. We rewind, I want to look at these lyrics real quick. Like, he's talking like about his albums. That's kind of crazy. Like, I didn't realize that, like, at the time a lot of those albums came out, they were rated low, and few years later, suddenly, you know, the Slim Shady LP, he said it himself, is top-notch. It's legendary. Be interesting to see if in 8 years later, his newer shit starts to become legendary in people's opinions when they go and re-rate it or read whatever. I just lost my English and had a stroke, but you get what I'm saying.
and I can still walk.
So be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold. I said be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold. I got a letter from a fan that said he's been praying for me every day, and for some reason it's been weighing on my mind heavy, cause I don't read every letter I get, but something told me to go ahead and open it. But why would someone pray for you when they don't know you? You didn't pray for me when I was local, and as I lay these vocals, I think of all the shit I had to go through just to get to where I'm at. I've already told you at least
That's interesting how he's thinking, like, why do they care now? Why didn't they care back then? Like, I don't know. Like, I kind of think it'd be interesting, like, if I could watch someone sit down and have a conversation with Eminem, not about, like, his raps and all that, like, his mentality where it comes to all this fame and, like, how it's really changed him. Because that's something I don't know, personally, I'd like to see is, like, the mentality of it all. Hey, maybe that's just me.
I had to go through just to get to where I'm at. I've already told you at least 1,000 times in these rhymes. Appreciate the prayer, but I've already got God on my side, and it's been one hell of a ride, hasn't it? Just watching it from an opposite standpoint, man, boys got to look nuts, and that's the only word I can think of right now on how to describe this shit. It's just like a vibe you get, go ahead and vibe to it, just hey. Watch what you wish for, cause I got the shit.
This whole song is just interesting, like, hearing how he's, like, kind of reflecting on his past, like, just kind of go back and being like, be careful what you wish for, because it might not be everything you imagined. That's basically the whole story of this song.
Be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, because it might just come back on you tenfold. I said, be careful what you wish for.
Man, this is crazy.
And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do.
This, honestly, this is probably one of my favorite Eminem songs I've heard. Like, it's not like Savage, but it's just like, because I like what he's talking about. It just was interesting to me to listen to it and hear him kind of break down, like, how crazy his life's been. Let me know if you want to hear my reaction to Cam. I did record that, so, but, like, I already seen it before, so I didn't remember it, but if you want to see that, let me know. I don't know if you guys want to see that, and I only want to put out shit you want to see. Either way, like, comment, subscribe, just do all that. And peace out, stay sexy, and have a great day. Bye. With